Ultimate engineering. How China built a train station in 9 hours. China's incredible high-speed rail. While some of us were probably sitting at our desk yawning into a coffee and blinking at our emails, over in China, a huge group of workers were busy creating the railway for a new train station, being so efficient at their job that it only took them 9 hours. Even Elon Musk tweets praises for the high efficiency of the railway project. The construction involves connecting three railways, the Ganlong Railway, the Ganrialong Railway, and Zhanglong Railway, to the newly constructed Nanlong Railway in Longyan, China's Fujian province. You'll be surprised to hear that the project was initiated at 6 p.m. and was completed at 2:20 a.m. the next day, with thousands of construction machinery and 1,500 railway staff. The project's purpose was to connect Longyan and Nanping, two cities in southeast China. According to Xinhua News, the Longyan-Nanping Railway was upgraded to over 250 kilometers, with a design allowing trains to run at a speed of 200 kilometers per hour, reducing travel time between the two cities from 7 hours to 90 minutes. According to Zhan Daosong, a deputy manager of China Teshizhou Civil Engineering Group, 7 trains and 23 diggers were employed, and the employees were divided into 7 groups to work on different jobs equally so that the project could be completed fast. China's incredible high-speed rail, or HSR, network. China has the largest and most extensively used high-speed railway network in the world. Lines crossed the nation in excess of 40,000 kilometers by the end of 2021, accounting for 2/3 of the world's total high-speed railway networks. Half of that amount has been built in the previous 7 years. By 2035, that network is planned to boom and set to reach 70,000 kilometers. The HSR network encompasses newly built rail lines with a design speed of 200 to 350 kilometers per hour, and 75% of Chinese cities with populations of 500,000 or more will have an HSR system by 2022. In 2021, China National Railways was operating over 9,600 high-speed trains on a daily basis. This included the world's only high-speed overnight sleeper service on certain chosen longer distance routes. More than 100 tunnels, each over 10 kilometers long, were also built as a part of this network. Several long-span bridges were built over natural obstacles like the Yangtze River. There were several innovations that were incorporated to suit the unique demands of China's varied terrain and climate. Chinese companies introduce autonomous driverless train operations and advanced signaling and control technology. An example of the driverless bullet trains connecting Beijing and ZHANGJIAKOU in northern Hubei province are able to hit speeds up to 350 kilometers per hour, making them the world's quickest autonomous trains. The brand new route opened in December 2019 and was deployed for the Beijing 2022 Winter Olympic and Paralympic Games has lowered travel times for the 174 kilometer journey from 2 hours to 45 minutes.
这个动车主他是首次采用了时速350公里自动驾驶的载客运行，这列车呢也是融合了这个高铁加5G加4K这些技术。 创新打造了这个世界首个这个在高铁上的5G超高清的移动演播室，绿色节能这些方面呢，这个车呢是大量的应用了环保可降解的材料，那么整个这个内装的材料的它的可回收率能够达到这个75%以上，我们选取了这个叫鹰隼造型的。 这样一个流线型的车头，它整个综合能耗方面能够降低10%以上，也就是说这一列车运行一年能够节约电力是180万度电。China
is aiming to make high-speed rail the preferred mode of transportation choice for domestic long-distance travel.
高铁，中国产的动车，这个是中国的一张亮丽的名片。
With the spread of the HSR comes an opportunity for China's ruling Communist Party and its leader, Xi Jinping, to use it for social cohesion, expanding political influence, and the consolidation of faraway regions with varied cultures into the mainstream.
Это целая группа городов. Третья полоса – это
пространственным развитием страны. У вас какой-то специальный орган есть?
有没有在中国有专门的部委或机构负责这个运输网络这个布局和发展？是什么部门？交通的部门，由他们来做这个规划。我们现在做这个立体的规划。就是有的呢，过去它的单独做公路做公路，铁路做铁路，现在是把它全部综合起来考虑，哪里适合公路，哪里适合铁路，不要造成一些浪费呀、造成这个最合理的这种交通分区，包括空中路线，这个都是有综合规划。
Pros and cons for China. The HSR projects are supported by investment funds and loans.They are strengthening China's position as the regional superpower in Asia, while also pulling in developing nations by proposing to build such rail lines there. These nations will probably rely on the rail networks built by China, further increasing their economic dependence on Beijing. Some studies show the new transport infrastructure could stimulate real estate business and attract foreign investment to central and western China. They can also increase the local government tax revenues.Researchers studying the economic impact of HSR found that in eastern China, one such rail station boosted the economy by nearly 9% within a range of 4 kilometers. In central China, this increase was found to be 3.6%, while in the northeast, it was 4.4%. However, researchers also noted that on average, each high-speed rail station in western China corresponded to a more than 1.5% fall in the intensity of local economic activity there. A study published in Journal China Industrial Economics in September showed that the construction of HSR lines has accelerated a brain drain from western regions as people from there move to the eastern region.Whatever the balance between the benefits and disadvantages of this system, China is keen on building even faster trains and extending the network across its national borders. So, that was it for today's video. And if you find it useful, hit the like button. For more videos, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any updates from our channel.